Okay, so good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm happy to be here. This is not first time of my stay in ICTP, maybe the 30th or 35th one. And but it is the first time when we came all together here to celebrate the birthday of our friend Boris Altshuler. And I want to start from the picture of 1987. It was also some advanced school under the supervision of Abrikosov in Dushanbe. And I want to, as a part of discussions of the character and properties of Boris, to show very important his part. It was our adventure. We bought 200 kilos of melons and 300 kilos of watermelons. And since 1987, I never ate so good. You see seriousness of these people. They are just before the military operation. So Boris, through all his life, conserved this interest for good food. And you see now with what interest and pleasure he is studying the menu in Easy in Torino. Then he continued his gastronomic studies, and then you see, this is in Tuscany, how he has new ideas about house, etc., after such tastings. Okay, I think that it is enough for introduction, and I would like to pass to the problem which a little bit younger than Boris, but not too much. In 1968, the Aslamazov-Larkin and simultaneously Maki in they discovered two effects, two different effects, because each group lost the another one. But totally, they took the essence of phenomenon which was not in the center of interest of superconducting community during more than 50 years. Because, more than 50 years. They discovered phenomenon which is called superconducting fluctuations. Actually, starting from Kamerlingh-Onnes, they in clean materials and in low temperature materials, superconducting transition is defined very well. And the problem of its definition did not rise at all. But when people, after the explanation of BCS of the nature of superconductivity and the prediction and the theory of second order, second kind superconductors by Abrikosov, people started to look for high critical parameters, and they started to study low dimensional systems and dirty systems. So already in films, superconducting transition was smeared enough. But it was not dramatic. Much more dramatic today, where you see for superconducting transition in high temperature superconductors or close to superconductor insulated transition. So it now to say that TC is a half of transition is just ridiculous. So the goal of fluctuation theory, to this practical sense, is to give to experimentalists possibility to define such parameters as TC, say microscopical parameters of superconductors, as TC, HC2, and tau phi. And actually, my talk will be devoted not to so new fields like topological metals, etc., but to this old story, but in some sense it will be the final cut, because we propose the general solution for any physical characteristic of superconductor, which can be for for dirty superconductors enough that we can be calculated in all phase diagram temperature magnetic field. So I want to recall you what are superconducting fluctuations. So close, what this is practically handbook story. So let's suppose that we are close to TC in normal phase, and I approach normal phase from above. So natura non facit saltus, told Romans. So nothing happens abruptly. So system feels in advance that superconducting transition is close. So the long electron correlations of the Cooper pair type takes place in the system. How long? So from uncertain principle, I can say that this is nothing works. Okay, you can see that the characteristic time from uncertain principle is h bar divided on some energy. What energy I can put in denominator to get characteristic time, lifetime of fluctuation Cooper pair? This should be something. I know that this Cooper pair will become eternal below TC. So in TC, this time should be infinite. So the only physical combination of energies which I can put in denominator is T minus TC. So the characteristics just from uncertain principle, I can get Ginzburg-Landau time. The microscopic theory provides us by the coefficient pi over 8. Okay, so I will present for future this in the form of dependence on relative temperature epsilon. So it is TC minus 1 divided epsilon, where epsilon is reduced temperature. Okay, now I will speak today about, I will speak about the dirty systems for simplicity. I can do this for clean also. So what will be the characteristic size of this Cooper pair? I have two electrons. They started, let's say, from the same point, and the time which they have is tau Ginzburg-Landau. So in diffusion motion, the distance between them during tau Ginzburg-Landau will be square root of diffusion coefficient for electron tau Ginzburg-Landau, and we get in this way the characteristic size of Cooper pair. This is Ginzburg-Landau length, which is more or less Xi BCS divided square root of reduced temperature. So these are large objects, and these objects have, we cannot treat them as the Boltzmann particles. These are waves, so we should consider the superconductor at the edge of its transition to normal metal from side of normal metal as the some box full of long waves. How I can, so this is just consideration from the Einstein and Geisenberg relations. Now I will pass to now I want to use the fact that these Cooper pairs are bosons. So I could write for them boson distribution for their distribution over momenta. And energy is the inverse. The characteristic energy is the inverse Ginzburg-Landau time. So this is T minus TC plus kinetic motion. So I can use Rayleigh-Jeans approximation. So I can expand this exponent and get that the concentration is defined by T over energy. Then for, not concentration, distribution. For to get concentration of these Cooper pairs, I will integrate over moment, momentum space. But, of course, I have to cut off this integration at the limits of applicability. Which limits of applicability I should use? Of course, the motion of the center of mass of Cooper pair, because I have some energy, T minus TC. This is a, let's say, energy of condensation. Plus, I have the energy of the kinetic energy of the motion of center of mass. what it is. It is p square over some effective mass, which I do not know, but evidently that momentum cannot be more than Xi Ginzburg-Landau, which I found, because they are soft. And this, if you want, is superfluidity, criterion Landau for superfluidity. So I cut off my integration, and I find nice relation. I do not know what is n from such consideration. But because I do not know what is m. But I know what is the relation n over m. This is temperature and Xi Ginzburg-Landau in power 2 minus d, where d is dimensionality. So I am not able to define concentration from such. I am not able to say it, what is the mass of Cooper pair, but I know n over m. But n over m is a combination which I need for conductivity, for Langevin formula for diamagnetic susceptibility, etc. So I have succeeded to too uncertainly to cancel out, and from such hand-waving consideration, I can reproduce a lot of formulas. The exact consideration for two-dimensional case gives me that n over m is t over p log epsilon. So the concentration of Cooper pairs close to TC diverges. This is what happens close to TC in two-dimensional case with superfluid density. This is, for instance, TC zeros. This is a mean field result. Fluctuations decrease TC. And already in the first order, in counting Hartree approximation, you see that fluctuations decrease critical temperature with which respect to imaginary mean field result for Ginzburg number, so this is strength of fluctuation, TC, and large logarithm of this Ginzburg number. So this is the noticeable decrease of TC, and I can, in two-dimensional case, find TC from Nelson jump. And it will be T, BC, BKT, Berezinski-Kosterlitz-Tauless transition. What is interesting, that the difference between this temperature and this only in first order calculated temperature shifted down by fluctuations differs only for four Ginzburg numbers. So this means that if I will perform all procedure of renormalization group, I will take into account all orders of fluctuations. I will change first order approximation only for Ginzburg, which is in logarithmic approximation negligible. So practically, just first step of perturbation theory makes me to coincide the renormalized by fluctuation TC with temperature of Berezinski Towers Kosterlitz. Now I will evaluate several, which effects we have. I still close to TC. So all this is still introduction. So having tau Ginzburg-Landau Xi and this N over M, I immediately can obtain all fluctuation phenomena. I can evaluate them. For instance, Aslamazov-Larkin, what does it mean? I mean, you have the opening of new channel of charge transfer. You have electronic system, but the fact, electrons scatters on impurities, but Cooper pairs, when electrons form this fluctuation Cooper pairs, they do not feel impurities. Impurities are integrated in their effective mass. So their motion is ballistic, and you can use just through the formula, with instead of scattering time, you use the lifetime, or what means to be scattered or to die is the same, because next burst of Cooper pair, then further Cooper pair will born with zero momentum, so it will start its life from the very beginning. So if I substitute here n over m, which I found 2e square and tau Ginzburg-Landau, I find that Aslamazov-Larkin, so conductivity due to Cooper pairs is proportional to reduced temperature in power d over 2 minus 2. And we get, without coefficient, famous Slamazov-Larkin formula. Next effect, which is beyond Ginzburg-Landau, is can be explained in terms of weak localization and Boris, and Khmelnytsky idea about the important role of self-intersecting trajectories. Imagine that you have some electron moves along some self-intersecting trajectory, and another electron moves in the opposite direction. They can form Cooper pair. And this Cooper pair will be anomalous, different from just two parallel. So we can calculate corresponding contribution conductivity in the spirit of weak localization. I can say that I have to calculate probabilities of formation of all such Cooper pairs until they are coherent, so up to tau phi, the maximal time. From minimum time is scattering time. So this probability is determined by well-known integral of weak localization theory. And then I have to take into account that they interact. We are close to transition. So I should multiply this probability on effective interaction, which is electron-electron interaction, and here Cooper logarithm. So in result, I will reproduce the result of Mackey-Thompson, Mackey and then Thompson calculation on fluctuation conductivity. Then, next, the fact that I form some Cooper pairs means that I steal electrons from the Fermi level. So increase of conductivity due to the opening of new channel of the charge transfer, plus this strange Cooper pairs and Mackey-Thompson version on the self-intersecting trajectories, all of them increase conductivity, but at the same time, we observe decreasing of Drude conductivity because you have less, now you have less electrons on their working places. So just using the Einstein expression for conductivity, and I allow to vary due to fluctuations, density of states and diffusion coefficient, I see that I can expect one renormalization due to renormalization of the density of states on the Fermi level, so evidently decrease, plus something may be related with the renormalization of the character of diffusion, what previously was not discussed. So easy to evaluate renormalization of conductivity due to density of states. You just take into account that instead of the effective number concentration of Cooper pairs is free concentration minus 2 concentration of Cooper pairs. You substitute this density which I just found, and you find that this correction will be proportional to logarithm. So it is less singular. And actually, it is it does not show up itself. Only if the pair transport, by some reasons, is suppressed or forbidden, like, for instance, in the transversal conductivity in layered systems. So renormalization of density of states show up itself, close to TC. The goal of my talk will show you what happens with quantum fluctuations. Actually, I'm so detailed in description what happens close to TC to show you the contrast when we will go to HC2 of zero. So at zero temperatures, the hierarchy of these contributions completely is different, you will see. So the last contribution, so renormalization of the diffusion coefficient can be calculated only diagrammatically, and it is not singular at all. It is square root of epsilon. So close to TC does not play any role. Far from TC, it is necessary to adjust asymptotics. So I want to summarize what we know. We know that tau Ginzburg, look, vicinity of TC, tau Ginzburg-Landau is H over some energy. This energy is T minus TC. Epsilon is reduced temperature. Corresponding time is Ginzburg-Landau time, and corresponding length is this one, is Ginzburg-Landau length. Now I move to HC2. So temperature is zero, and I approach HC2 from above. So the question will be established in the following way. How is forming abrikosa lattice when I approach transition from above? Actually, Levas-Lamazov gave this problem to his PhD student in 1979. I was also a PhD student, but it was not resolved. It was not me. I had another problem. Nevertheless, when I solved it, I recalled that it was established. So, formation of abrikosa lattice, how it happens? I propose again, it is possible to write correspondent propagators and get, of course, I invented these explanations after calculation. So, I won't repeat the same way. So, I approach HC2 from above. Should be some characteristic time of fluctuations, superconducting fluctuations happens, quantum, but happens. What is the characteristic time? Again, Geisenberg says me that it is H bar divided some energy. And this energy should turn zero in transition. What energy I have in my hands? Cycloton frequency for Cooper pairs. Only what, so if I will use as a, this quantum fluctuations energy, the difference between omega cycloton at the current H minus the same value of HC2, I will have the analogy with T minus TC for quantum phase transition. And the answer will be delta BCS H bar. This is a reduced magnetic field, which characterizes me. This is a parameter which is very, and I pass transition due to this parameter. So I see that corresponding quantum fluctuations time will be H bar delta BCS minus 1, H bar. Please look, it is all is very similar. The role of T minus epsilon plays H bar. Look, I'm sure that you remember what is delta minus 1. So look, I am a little bit above HC2. Below HC2 is abrikosa lattice. And delta minus 1 is a period of rotation of Cooper pair in vertex. So I see that I found some time much longer than one rotation. Fluctuation Cooper pair should form, if it is formed at zero temperature in magnetic field, it is obliged to rotate. But rotation is very short. I see that correlation remains much longer than one rotation. So I arrive to the idea that this is what happens below HC2. So I believe that the superconducting fluctuations from above, they're not, of course, now there is no place for this box with long waves. You have clusters of vertices. You can take, being experimentalist, you can take good camera and put exposition. You have two possibilities, to make exposition shorter than quantum fluctuations time or longer. If you will have longer, you will see nothing because all will smear out. If you have short exposition time, you will see these clusters, which are, let's say, precursor effects for future abrikosa lattice. You approach HC2, these clusters grow, and fluctuation become slower and slower. In the point of HC2, cluster will be infinite, and it will be eternal. So this is scenario, as I see, how fluctuations happens above TC. Again, I can have in hands tau quantum fluctuations and xi, the size of this, size of these clusters, I can by hands evaluate a lot of things. The same contribution of paraconductivity, the Nernst effect, diamagnetic effect, etc. So, and compare them with the results of microscopic calculation. So I see the diagram in the following way. Here you see well-known diagram of superconductor. This second order. This is a Meissner phase. This is abrikosa lattice. Here happens who knows what, vertex liquid. From above, Here I have some Rayleigh jeans picture of long Ginzburg-Landau waves. Here I have this clusters of fluctuating Cooper pairs, quantum fluctuations, which lead to formation of a big oscillator lattice. And here, when I move along HC2 of temperature, at some point happens, so you have long waves with characteristic size Xi Ginzburg-Landau here. Here, I do not know Xi Ginzburg-Landau or not, but some size, which shrinks. Simultaneously, you have growing decreasing magnetic lengths, corresponding to rotation of Cooper pairs. At some point, they become of the same order, and the long waves break in vortices. So from the wave picture, you pass to vertex picture. The interesting that in the result of our microscopic calculations for differences, we see at what temperature it happens. It happens more or less for NMR relaxation. We see that you cannot speak more about waves at TC close to 0.6. So you cannot find this in numbers. This is some numerical result. I will show it. So now I will pass to microscopic. This is well-known 10 diagrams which describe contribution to conductivity from fluctuations, so all first-order fluctuation contributions. I show them only to identify. So to Aslamazov-Larkin contribution correspond this diagram. You see that entrance of electric field and exit of it are connected only by Cooper pair propagators. So this is a purely superconducting transition. This is Mackey-Thompson diagram. These four diagrams I will call DOS diagrams because you see that all of them are related to renormalization of one electron density in presence of fluctuation pair. So you see that electron meets virtually the electron which moves in time in opposite direction. They form Cooper pair, then the first one continues its life. So this is a renormalization of densities. And there is a group of diagrams which you renormalize vertex. So they correspond to renormalization of the diffusion coefficient. Now, please do not pay attention on the, I will show some formula. What is no, this is not next time. So what is a wavy line? Wavy line is just the, this is a Cooper ladder. So interaction of two electrons, 1, 2, 10, 100 times, and formation, this two particle Green function, which corresponds to the life of Cooper pair. And it is written here in the most general way. So for any temperature and for any magnetic field and dynamical, so T is reduced temperature, H is reduced magnetic field, and this function E, M, corresponds to M's Landau level, any temperature, any magnetic field, and frequency. Corresponding Couperon can be written in terms of, okay, this is just account for impurities. This psi function has some nice, this is a psi function is a logarithmic derivative of Euler gamma function. It has poles at zero and minus integer numbers, and this is important function of the theory. This is the answer. So the answer, you can see, I just want to say that this part is Aslamazov-Larkin contribution. This part is Mackey-Thompson contribution. And this part corresponds to density of states renormalization. This part corresponds of renormalization diffusion coefficient. What is interesting? I show this terrible formula for two reasons. First reason is to show you the, that exists some solution which can be used. I will show what it is next slide. But what is important? Important that this works in all phase diagram above line HC2 of T. Important that these four contributions we discussed in detail close to TC. But this expression allows me to get, for instance, so here you see some interesting already results. Our believe that fluctuations always increase conductivity, so all is red, is correct, close to TC. This is superconductor, this is TC. But exists some line where total fluctuation correction changes sign. Here, it becomes negative and very negative, close to quantum phase transition at HC2. This is the surface which shows me full behavior of fluctuation conductivity as a function of temperature and magnetic field. I especially turned the usual presentation of superconducting phase diagram to show you what happens close to HC2. Look, here fluctuation correction is very negative. And what is fantastic, that Aslamazov-Larkin contribution exactly equal to anomalous Mackey-Thompson and equal with opposite sign to those contributions. All of them die as a T square in the region of quantum fluctuations, where when T over TC is much less than H minus HC2 over HC2. So when the temperature is so weak, that is less than reduced magnetic field. Here, and all story now is managed by renormalization of diffusion coefficient, which gives you quantum corrections log 1 over h. This result was first obtained, this result, not this discussion, but this result first was obtained by Galitsky and Larkin. Here you can see the fittings with this formula of some experimental results of Baturina and company. And now I have still 5 minutes, so I will shortly show you where else were applied these ideas. We, with Skvortsov, Galitsky, and Serbin, we did this fluctuoscopy of Nernst effect, which was in the focus of attention after the experiments of Ong, which attributed some magic properties to Nernst effect in pseudogap phase, but then group of Kamran-Benya from Paris demonstrated that the effect of fluctuations, that the Nernst effect in low temperature superconductor with critical temperature 0.38, not 400 times, but 5,000 times more than in normal phase. So we have succeeded to calculate again for any magnetic field and temperatures the Nernst effect and to find all asymptotics and the position of maximum, which is very important because today people are interested how to find for new materials critical field analyzing properties of superconductor above TC. This is a group of Taillefer and the same Kamran-Benya. Our attention, very recently, it was published 1 week ago, Attilio Rigamonti and Alessandro Lasciaffi told us that they observe peak of quantum fluctuations in nuclear magnetic relaxation rate in some superconductor, this yttrium, so it was critical temperature 15K. So we performed here, there is, so we can start from the Karinga law for relaxation of nuclear magnetic relaxation rate, and which is proportional to the square of density of states. So the first evident effect is that the density of states decreases, so you should have a gap, fluctuation gap in W. But above TC was an observed peak, and this peak was debated many years ago. We, with Mohit Randeria, proposed the following explanation, that the same localization diagram. Imagine that here you have the nuclear. So electron moves along self-intersecting trajectory, comes here, reflects from the this nuclear, changes its momentum, the spin flip, and then interacts with itself in past. And this corresponds to Mackey-Thompson diagram, but not those one which was for conductivity. For conductivity, you had two loops and interactions. Here you have one loop, like in weak localization, so sign is the opposite. In result, you have competition of two contributions. One of this strange self Cooper pair and corresponding positive relaxation, and opening of gap in NMR relaxation rate due to density of states. In result, you have when tau phi is short, long, so this effect is this process is effective, and you indeed can have the positive contribution. But when you will study this in all for along the line hc2 of t, so you see that there is some point, even for tau phi infinity, there is some point where this effect is just due to magnetic length, which kills you it. So this is, and the last picture which I will show you is beautiful application for tunnel spectroscopy. So you have a tip, and you have fluctuating superconductor. So when electron enters here, a tunnel in your superconductor, so there are two possibilities. One possibility is to enter in normal region and you have depleted density of states, or other possibility, if electron was lucky, it during this energetic relaxation length meets some superconducting region. This electron would like to enter in it, but it's his chemical potential still is different. So it can extract from vacuum the electron of corresponding chemical potential with the opposite momentum, form Cooper pair, and enter in this superconducting region. The hole moves along its trajectory back. Yes. And result that you have the large-scale gap and then some small T minus Tc square, T minus Tc width, zero bias singularity, which allows you to extract tau phi in principle. You can see the surfaces which we calculated for zero magnetic field. And here you can see the experimental curves of Benjamin Sesepe, which are very similar, but they do not see this zero bias anomaly. That's all. I want to show that Boris, because I maybe demonstrated only his interest to buying of melons, etc. But here his academic, let's say, with his academic, how to define it? Okay, degrees, etc. Yeah. And finally, nevertheless, we do the same, but we changed place from Dushanbe. Finally, we finished at Paris, but all is the same. Boris, happy birthday to you.